everybody. Welcome to Yin Yoga. Before we begin, maybe you'd like to grab a blanket or a pillow or a bolster, something to help when you come into these poses. What I'd like you to remember is that Yin Yoga is about the mind, body, and soul. It's a slower practice yoga. It's one where you're connecting your mind and letting yourself be still. We come into poses, they're all on the mat, and we hold these poses when we come into the edge. And that is when you come slowly into the pose. Find that resistance in the area that we're targeting and then settle into that pose, keeping that mind clear as much as possible. I hope everyone is well during this time. This is a perfect time to do Yin Yoga. And just come to your breath. When you find that it's hard to hold on to this pose, or maybe your mind is going in different directions, surrender that mind and come back to your breath. And always remember that this is your practice. So bring yourself a bolster or a block or even a rolled up towel, whatever you might have handy, and come back and join us. So we're going to begin in a comfortable seat, Sukhasana. So we're going to sit up nice and tall. Bring those shoulders up and back. And then bring those palms up to receive these good vibrations that everybody's putting out there. There's so many people cheering the heroes of the hospitals and the doctors and the nurses. And we can do that just by receiving this vibration, this beautiful good vibes that we can get. Bring your index finger and your thumb together in a mudra to connect. And then we're going to come for a little meditation to begin our practice. So we're going to start with three deep breaths. So as you inhale that breath, fully fill that belly all the way up. And then release it, open your lips and sigh out. Inhale deeply. Let it go. Last one. Let it go. And now begin your practice of meditation, finding that breath, that inhale, and that long exhale through the nose. And just listen to your breath, bringing your mind to a place of peace, to that place that you find that happiness, that serenity. And then come to that stillness of meditation, finding yourself at a peaceful beach. The sky is blue. There's small puffs of clouds in the sky. You're listening to the sound of the ocean as the waves crash against the shore ever so gently. And then they ebb back into the ocean. Follow this movement of the ocean with your breath. Sitting up nice and tall. Sure. from you today. And surrender to this beautiful practice today. Take a moment to set an intention for your practice. Maybe you need to bring in more patience, more gratitude, more peacefulness. Maybe you need to let go of fear, of worry. Center. Bring those thumbs to the sternum and take a bow down to set your intention for your practice today. Inhale that intention and then let it go into the universe. Bring your thumbs to your third eye and then bow down to seal that intention in. And slowly come back up. And then just for three breaths, just come to stillness. Slowly open your eyes. Bring those arms out to the side. Bring those arms up overhead just for a beautiful stretch. And then let those arms just come down, wiggling those wrists. And let's all meet in a beautiful tabletop. Taking your time to get to that tabletop. Take your hands, widen those fingers, open them like starfish. Your knees are about two fist distance apart. We're just gonna start out by opening up our back before we come into these long poses that we're holding. We're gonna do a little bit of a flowing kind of cat-cow. So take an inhale, drop that belly, bring that chest forward, that throat open on that inhale. And then as you exhale, tuck that chin, arch that back as you've pressed into the floor, and then you're going to bring yourself down into a semi-child's pose. And then as you inhale, coming into that cow. Exhale, come into that cat. Two more, just like this, opening up the back. Inhale. Really listen to this breath. Exaggerate on these inhales and exhales. Inhale one last time for that cow. Exhale for that cat. Come back into that tabletop, widen those knees on that mat. We're coming into child's pose for our first pose. Bring those toes together as you slowly come down into that child's pose. Again, finding that edge, find that resistance in those inner thighs and those hips, and then bring those fingers out as far as you can. And you want your forehead to be touching the mat. So if it does not, bring a bolster or that blanket to put underneath your forehead and come down into that child's pose. Once you get here, take that time to let go and surrender to this pose. We'll be here for about 3 minutes. Remember to keep that mind still, free of clutter. Let it go. Thank you. Take three breaths here. Now on the next inhale, very mindfully, we're coming back to that tabletop. Rearranging, bringing those knees back to about those two distance apart. Take a moment, get yourself situated. We're gonna take that right arm. We're just gonna make two nice circles, opening up this shoulder and those joints in that shoulder blade and the arm. Take that right arm out to the side. And then you're gonna thread it underneath that left arm as you bring your shoulder down to the ground and your head. Now, if your head does not come, again, bring a bolster or that blanket, place it under your head. So you can stay right here if you'd like to take this a little further. Remember, we're in these poses for 3 minutes. Bring that foot out to the side and have it grab with your fingers. Find that edge, find that pose. This left arm can be up over your head, or you can bring it and open that chest up and bring it behind your shoulder. Wherever you are, settle into that pose. Close your eyes and just breathe. Offer poses, I offer them to go if you'd like to go a little deeper. You do not have to do them. Remember, this is your practice. You want to feel that edge, that resistance, but you do not want to feel any pain. You want to take this time now to connect with your soul. Your mind, your body, in this beautiful yin practice. those three breaths here. And very mindfully, as we come out of this pose, you're going to take that left hand down. If your left foot is out, bring it back to meet your right. Slowly make your way back up into that tabletop. I'm going to just turn around to show you this next pose. We're coming into as lizard in yoga poses, but for yin, it is called dragon. So we're going to take that left foot, we're going to bring it right to the outside of our left hand. Your right knee is going to come back down onto the ground, letting that top of your foot lay and rest on the floor. So you have an option here. You can stay here. You can bring your bolster in and come down on your bolster. The idea is you want to feel that stretch in your hip. And then if this does not work for you, if you'd like to go a little further, you can come onto the edge of that, outside of that left foot, and bring your hand onto your knee and take a twist and come into a twisted dragon. But wherever you are, find the pose you want to come into and settle into that pose. To the breath. If you're staying with your foot flat on the ground, just have your arm equal with your leg as that right leg is back. And settle into this pose. This is a very extreme hip opener. Here you should be feeling this edge into that left hip, into the inner thigh on both legs. And breathing, taking that breath. We'll take those three breaths here. Taking that breath, sending it down to those hips. Beautiful. You guys are doing good. Now take an inhale very, very, very mindfully. Make your way up. If you have a bolster, just remove it, place it to the side. And then just bring that foot in a little bit. We're going to come into a little bit of a runner stretch. So come up, take an inhale, just come settle back. into just a counter pose here for about 5 breaths. This should feel good. And then make your way back up. Back into that tabletop as we go on to the other side. So come into that tabletop. I'm gonna take that left arm, make through 2 circles with that left arm, just opening up the joints here on the collar. Take that left arm out to the side. We're gonna thread it underneath our right side this time as we come down. Again, if you need that pillow or bolster under your head to bring your head to the ground. So settle in here. Taking that right arm, bringing that right arm either overhead or behind you. And again, if you'd like to go a little further with this pillow, you can bring that right foot out to meet your hand. But wherever you are, find that edge, find that resistance, and then settle into that pose. About 30 seconds here in this pose. Take those 3 breaths. On this next inhale, bring that right arm to help you come back up. If your right leg is out, bring it back to that tabletop to meet that right leg, that left, sorry. Take a moment, take an inhale. We're gonna come into that dragonfly. So you're gonna take that right foot, bring it to the outside of that right hand. Again, just staying in this posture, bring that left knee back as far as it can go, giving that stretch in this groin area. If you're staying here just like this in your right hand, your arm is next to your right leg, or take your bolster. And then if you were on the other side and you come on the edge of that right foot, bring the edge to your pinky toe, open that right leg, and come in to settle into dragonfly. Become still here. Close the eyes. Settle into the pose. When you start feeling that edge get to you, bring that breath there. Send that breath to that edge. Hang in there. We have about another 30 seconds or so. These hip openers are the hardest. We'll take those three breaths here. And you guys did it. Take that next inhale. Wherever you are, just come back. Move your bolster if you had one. Take that right foot, come onto your heel, and just settle back into that runner's pose. Just a modified pose just to help open that hip, let that hip just kind of settle down. Some of the harder poses, we come into counter poses. And slowly make your way back up. Come into a seat. Here you're going to take the left leg is in front of you on an angle. And then that right leg's just gonna come in front of that left leg. So you want your right ankle to be in front of your left knee and your right knee kind of on, you're kind of in a square without being, if you'd like to come into full square, you can bring those, that right leg on top of that left leg and the right knee is underneath. Again, here, if you'd like to take your pillow and your bolster and bring that with you, we're coming into square. This is another intense hip opener, and then after that, I promise you, we'll go into more comforting ones. Take a nice deep inhale, and then as you exhale, come as forward as you can to where you feel in that right hip that nudge, that resistance. And then when you find that, just come a little bit further down and just stay right here in the stillness. So if you do not have a bolster, you can use your hands, place them on your legs, find your wherever you're going to be, come into that, settle, and then close your eyes, come into that pose. Always remember our hips, our right hips and left side, right side are always different. Each day one might be a little bit more acceptable of poses than the other side. Remember to breathe into that resistance, to that edge. Send the energy there, send that breath there. This is where yin yoga challenges you when these poses become challenging. When you find that you want to come out of it, we are resilient people. You can stay in this pose. We have about a minute more. We have three breaths here. Take that last one in. As you exhale, just see if your body will let you come down just a little bit more on that exhale. Beautiful. And then on that inhale, just slowly make your way up. Take that right leg. Ah, yes. Bring it behind you now. We're coming into deer. So this right foot is behind you, this right leg. This left foot is going to be placed near your knee. Take your bolster, your blanket, bring it to the outside of your left side. You're going to take a nice deep inhale as you twist. You're gonna come down onto that mat in your bolster and come into deer with that twist. And then slowly settle into here. It's a nice counter twist too. That square, releasing that right hip. Giving us a little bit more of a supportive pose if you're on a bolster. need like a little bit more of a twist. Come on up, twist a little more, and then bring that right cheek down to the ground or to that bolster, and we'll get more of a twist. We'll take those three beautiful breaths here. And that next inhale, bring those hands to the ground. Slowly make your way up, taking your time, twisting, coming back to the center. And yes, we do have another side to do. So again, now this time, that right leg is going to come in front of you parallel, and that left leg is going to come in front of that right leg. If this does become too much, you can just bring that left leg straight out and just bring that right ankle on top of that left knee. Or if you want to come further, bring that left leg, that left foot over that right knee, coming into that square. Find that seat that's comfortable for you. Find that edge. Sit up nice and tall. And come into that pose. This side's a little more difficult for me. My left hip is a little bit more of a nudge. So I struggle with this side. Remember, yin is about slowing down your practice. It's the opposite of a vinyasa yang class. Yin is to slower down that movement, settle into poses, finding that stillness in your mind. And when you think about these connective tissues and this fascia that surrounds all your bones and your joints, when you use these connective tissues, you're bringing this beautiful milky liquid to these bones and these joints. Sometimes in this craziness of our world, we never take time to settle down and just come to that stillness, whether it's meditation or a milder practice of yoga. Sometimes we don't take that time to just come to our own self. We have about 30 seconds in this pose. Maybe you'd like to take it, maybe go down a little bit deeper. Really feeling that edge, taking that edge to its peak for those last few breaths. Sending that breath and that energy to that hip, that left hip, that outer hip. Take one more breath here. Exit, bring it down. And then slowly make your way up. Taking that time. Taking that bolster if you have it, your blanket. Maybe you don't have anything. Slowly take that left leg out. And you're gonna bring it around behind you. As that right foot now is right in front of that left knee. Take a moment to take that deep inhale and then twist over to the right side this time. And again, for more of a twist, when you come down, take that left cheek onto the bolster or the mat. If that's too much, then just place the right cheek down. Remember, this is your practice. Do what works for you. But wherever you are, come in, settle down, and settle that mind. We'll take those three breaths here. Excuse me. On that next inhale, bring those hands to the floor. Slowly make your way up. Taking your time, bring those legs out in front, Bring the feet down to the floor. Bring your hands behind you. And then just slowly windshield wiper those knees back and forth. We have one final pose before Shavasana. If you do have a bolster or just take a nice rolled up blanket or a towel, we're going to place the bolster underneath our back side. So you want it basically to come here because you want your shoulders to lay down over that blanket, that bolster. We're coming into fish. So as you slowly come into this, make sure that your shoulders are coming down over the back of this bolster or blanket. Bring those arms up as you let those arms come down to the side. Let your head drop back. Open that throat chakra. Let that crown chakra shine. All your chakras are open here. And just breathe. Let the feet sway open to the sides. Relax into this pose. We won't be here long. Just a little counter pose of all the twists and the forward folds that we've done. Heart opening up, letting that love come out, coming back to your intention that you set for the beginning of your practice, what you might need a little bit more of, or what you might need to let go. Just about three more breaths here. Really filling up that belly with the breath as you inhale. Letting it go. Listen to the sound of that last inhale. And then exhale. Then slowly come out of this pose, very gently, bringing yourself up. And the best part of any yoga practice is our Shavasana. And here you get to stay for as long as you'd like. So take that time to maybe use that bolster under your legs because your hips might need it. Maybe when you come back, bring the soles of your feet together. Come into Supta Baddha Konasana, reclined bound pose. Wherever you feel like you want to come into for your final Shavasana. Remember, this is your practice. Stay as long as you'd like. Stay into that mindfulness. Hopefully the peace of this world and the kindness that everyone has been showing lately, it's been amazing that this will continue when this pandemic is over. Thank you for sharing your practice with me today, my home. To everyone out there, stay safe, stay healthy, stay home. And always remember that the divine light that shines within me honors and bows to that divine light within each and every one of you. Peace be with you, love be with you, and health be with you. Namaste, everyone. So come down into your Shavasana. Find yourself in that beautiful yogi dessert, as Dawn always taught us. And be at peace. Namaste, everyone.